So almost universally, ancient texts and traditions see us and our relationship to the world in a way that modern science is only beginning to understand, and it's all about cycles of time. Our ancestors viewed our lives in terms of cycles. Nature is a cyclic experience, and some of the cycles are very obvious. The cycles of day and night, for example, or the 28-day cycle of a woman's menstrual cycle, or the 28 days of the moon. Those are obvious cycles. But our ancestors were telling us about cycles that cover vast periods of time that only now we're beginning to understand. 5,000 years, 10,000 years, 100,000 year cycles. Cycles so vast that no one is here now at the end of the cycles that was here when they began. So the question is, what do those cycles tell us about our lives? And how can they help us to understand the changes that we're experiencing in our world today? As a scientist, I began exploring this through the principle of nature's patterns, patterns that are called fractals. And probably the best way to understand a fractal is simply through an example. If we think of an atom, for example, the model of an atom with a small nucleus in the center and the electrons that move around that nucleus, that pattern is exactly the same pattern that we see in the solar system, for example, with the sun in the center and planets moving around the sun. I remember when I was in school and I looked at the textbooks and I saw the first picture of the atom, and I thought to myself, wow, that atom looks just like a solar system except it's smaller. And this is precisely the point. This is the power of fractal patterns in our lives. If we can understand the principle of a pattern on one level, and that same principle helps us to understand the same pattern on a bigger level. If we understand what helps those electrons to move around the nucleus of an atom, it helps us to understand why planets move around the sun the way they do. This is the power of fractals. In the book Fractal Time, what I have done is apply this principle to the cycles of time itself. And it says that if we can understand the little patterns of the past as they repeat in the present, it gives us insight into the things that happen in our lives. Cycles of love and romance and abundance, or lack and loss and hurt. If we can understand the cycles in terms of our civilization, the entire rise and fall, cycles of war and peace and great civilizations does repeat, and it repeats with a regularity in terms of patterns, fractal patterns that we can understand and apply in our lives. This is the power of fractal time. It all begins with the understanding of a cycle. When a cycle begins in our lives, a cycle begins with what is called a seed event, S-E-E-D. A seed event sets into motion a pattern of energy that will continue and repeat time after time until something changes that pattern. And it will follow a rhythm. It will happen on a cyclic basis using very, very simple mathematics, the same mathematics that govern much of life as we know it today. In the book Fractal Time, what I've done is explore this principle and developed a very simple calculator, a time code calculator, that allows us to identify seed events from the past, any time in the past. Seed events like the 1929 collapse of the economic market in the world, or seed events of 1914, the first world war in modern times. Seed events of joyous things as well. They don't have to be bad things. But when we identify the seed for an event, what we also do is we give ourselves the power to know when the conditions of that event may reasonably be expected to repeat again in our future. And if we know when the conditions are present, then we also know when we have the optimum opportunity to change that pattern. And these are called choice points. Physicist in 1958, his name was Dr. Hugh Everett III, coined the term choice point as a point between cycles. When one cycle ends before the next cycle begins, there's a moment where neither exists, and that is the place where our choices have the greatest potency. And while we can certainly choose at any time in our lives, at the places where the choices have the greatest power, that is where we have the greatest opportunity to change the patterns of the past. Globally, patterns of war, for example, and suffering, or personally, patterns of hurt and lack. Those kinds of patterns are the ones that we can learn from with the greatest efficiency, and this is what our ancestors were telling us about the power of cyclic time. So as we come to understand fractal time and the role that it plays in our lives, I think it's no accident that only now, as we find ourselves within a few years of the end of a great world age, when the experts tell us that we're facing the greatest number of crises ever in recorded human history, with the greatest threat to our existence, only now are we beginning to understand the role of the cycles and our role in identifying where in the cycle we have the potential to change those frightening patterns of our past. And this is one of the reasons I feel such passion, and that I am so positive about our future, because what I'm seeing personally, professionally, behind the scenes and publicly, is that we are learning. It's a difficult learning process, but I'm encouraged by what I see. I believe in our species. I believe in humankind. I believe in our family ship that brings us together to transcend, and not just survive, but transcend, to become better people and create a better world. And this is where we find ourselves right now. This is the foundation of fractal time and the new world age. I want to thank you personally for all that you do to become a better person in your own life, and by doing so to create a better world, because our individual choices become our collective answer to this time in history.